What's
up?
How are you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm doing good. I felt really good about my outfit today, but then I saw your outfit and you look super cute. Oh. Can you show the camera your shoes? I love her shoes.
Yes.
And she had like the gorgeous, is it the camera?
Yes, it's the camera.
The Fendi. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's like she's stunning on me, so I'm going to have to.
Well, I love those pants.
Thank you.
They're adorable.
These are cute, right? I mean, I just felt like something like kind of summery. And,
yeah.
And I love pink.
Yes. Pink. We're both wearing pink.
Right.
We got the vibe today.
It's always good. I know our camera guy is all in black, but he's always all in black. So we're rocking the pink over here. Well, listen. Okay. So tell us who you are, the name of your company, what you do.
All right, I'm Brianna Pollard with Storybook Home Photography, and we take images and descriptions and put them together to tell a home story.
Yeah, I really like that. The photography that you do is top-notch, and also something that I think is so important because everything's so digital right now is the search engine optimization. Mm-hmm. I have a real estate column right now. It runs in a couple of places and online. And I've done, search engine optimized writing before, so I know how important it is.
Right.
Talk to us about that portion, because you search engine optimize and use keywords when you're writing that. You do the photos,
mm-hmm.
and then you do the description.
The property description.
I'm probably explaining it worse than you would, so.
So, yeah, the property description for MLS, Zillow, wherever else you want to put it, Trulia. So you're basically thinking, SEO is search engine optimization. So it means that you are making something more easily found by people on the internet. So you're going to gain more exposure. You're going to get more leads, more views, more clicks. And you do that by putting in phrases that people are going to search for. So people search for, three bedroom home in Championsgate or pool home near the airport, mm-hmm. and you want to have those phrases and those keywords in the description, mm-hmm. so that it can be found by more people so that you can get those leads.
Yeah. Like people are not necessarily searching, I don't know. Like I see a lot of descriptors, mm-hmm. and it's so funny. I was like, I was thinking about doing this. Me and my friend Steve were talking about doing a video on this, but we're talking about the euphemism words like cream puff. It's kind of an old school word, but
yeah.
you'll see them frequently, or, people aren't searching for honey, stop the car,
Yeah, exactly. People use a lot of flowery language that doesn't really do much. But there are some adjectives and descriptors, mm-hmm. that can be very important and have a heavy weight for that listing description. So we were talking earlier about, mm-hmm. the word luxury.
Mm-hmm.
So that actually can help sell, especially bottom tier price homes, 8% more than the price that was expected to sell for.
Mm-hmm.
So another word would be stainless.
Mm-hmm.
I believe another word is captivating. Those words sell around, I think, 4 to 6% more. Just having that word in the, mm-hmm. description can really help the home sell faster and for more money.
Yeah, because it's kind of planting that idea in their head, like, okay, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's like, what was the first one that you mentioned?
Luxurious.
Okay, mm-hmm. So it helps kind of set the scene for that.
Yeah. And even if I can't, even the home might not be luxurious, but there may be something in it that is luxurious.
Right.
Maybe the type of granite, mm-hmm. on the countertops, or maybe the master bathroom it feels luxurious because of all the natural light from the skylights coming in. And, maybe there's like some nice hardware in there that might feel luxurious.
Right.
So I try to find anything where I can use that word.
Right.
But, sometimes it is hard to, if it's like a fixer-upper, you're not really going to use the word luxurious.
Right.
So we're gonna be careful with those words and not be misleading.
We're gonna optimize different words.
Yeah.
X-rapper. Like not haunted.
Right.
I saw that somebody had a sign writer as a joke. Not haunted. I'm like,
I've seen that too.
It's cute.
Yeah, and it, with the different tiers too, you have like your bottom tier, your, mm-hmm. middle tier, and your top tier. And there's words that have different weights for those tiers,
Okay.
So for, an upper, tier listing, you're gonna use the word private.
But right.
You wouldn't necessarily use that for a lower tier.
Okay.
Price money. Yeah.
Okay. Awesome.
So, yeah.
And then I noticed we just sold a property, put it on the market, over in Weston Bay. And I noticed like it sold, obviously I do my end on the marketing, but the portion that you did, I thought worked out beautifully. We had a full price offer the first day.
Cool.
So,
awesome.
But I noticed you were doing, mentioning the landmarks,
mm-hmm.
because people are also maybe searching for those things, or that might help it pop up a little bit more. You're talking,
exactly.
about what's in the area.
Exactly. Yeah. You really want to be locally focused, because you can have these SEO terms hours, but it's like you're appealing to everybody everywhere. Mm-hmm. You've got to make it more focused, and
right.
you're going to be targeting fewer people, but that's going to be better leads for you because right. they make more sense.
Those are the people that want to live
Those are the
there.
People that want to be in that area.
Yeah.
And so, you know, you can say by Orlando International Airport because someone might work at the airport and want to right. be near there. So that's mm-hmm. where they're looking. You know, certain community names, neighborhood names, city names, even certain builders, Meritage mm-hmm. homes, you know, like mm-hmm. you have to use those specific keywords to target those people for those areas.
Yeah. I mean, if somebody has maybe owned a Meritage home before mm-hmm. and then they're, and it's so funny that you say that because the listing that we just did, they're buying a Meritage home.
Yeah.
So, yeah, but I mean, then people kind of know, maybe they've bought one before. Okay. I know what to expect. So if they're kind of looking for a certain standard of quality and they hear that, they know, okay, this is, so yeah, I like that it was a marriage of, you know, descriptors for the house and the area, and the way it was all put together. Mm-hmm. You know, I noticed you're telling me, so like, there were some things that we were going to add and remove, and you're like, okay, well, let me know.
Yeah.
Because we want to do, there's some sequencing to it, right?
Yeah. The way that I sequence it is I start off with location because I feel like when, a buyer is looking at the listing online, they click through all the photos, they're able to see the layout, they're able mm-hmm. to see what kind of countertops and floors there are, you know, so we can touch on that later in the description. They've already seen it. So I really want to touch on the location, where it's at, how you're going to spend your weekends, where your kids are going to go to school, mm-hmm. what it's actually like to live in the home,
yeah.
because that's something that the pictures don't convey.
Right. Yeah. Well, if you did a beautiful job of it. And like I said, I mean, as somebody, I've written the search engine optimized stuff, and it definitely, you have to do that today. I mean, because like you said, everybody, we were talking about it with the stager before now. I mean, everybody looks online now.
There's so much clutter too everywhere. You yeah. gotta stand out.
There's a lot. Exactly. And it does help you stand out. Mm-hmm. And the photos are a big part of that too. Your photos are gorgeous. So tell us about like your philosophy when you're taking the photos of a house.
So my philosophy with photos, there's a lot of different methods of photography. So I personally use like a flambient method. So I use flash and natural light to try to get the best realistic image possible.
I like that, flambient.
Yes. Flash and ambient. So I try to get the most realistic lighting possible, bright and pretty, you know, and that's what I do. There's also HDR methods that can really help, but I find that sometimes it can look a little muddy. It can look a little almost like painted. It doesn't look as realistic.
Right.
So I've found that a lot of people come to me because they don't like the HDR style
right.
for real estate. It can be a great method, I think, for other things, but for real estate, it's not the best in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Because it can look a little fake and it can misrepresent the home.
Right.
And so I think that the flambient method really helps to show the home in its best natural, realistic light.
Yeah, like it's just like the best possible
the
first
true color tones. Yeah,
yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's like an Instagram filter, but not the one with bunny ears.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? People
right.
will show up. If that has happened. I've shown listings, and people are like,
this doesn't look like the photo.
It doesn't look anything like it looked like online.
Mm-hmm. My Tinder date is not what I expected.
Excuse me, sir. You are not 6 feet.
Yes. Yes.
yes. You don't want to, and that does piss people off.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, that's
a great
way. Yeah, it's a great way to turn somebody off because, you know, if it's so altered, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? And the MLS does have restrictions. Obviously, we can't, like, if the grass is dead, we can't make it fully green and we never do stuff like that. But even
right.
if it's interior, if it's just totally, like, you know, touched up to death,
mm-hmm.
it's not going to be realistic. It could put somebody off. But I know you did some other good things in that we had the Zillow walkthrough
mm-hmm.
and we had sort of a 3D view.
Yeah.
So that's really nice because then people can see the layout.
Yeah. Zillow has just rolled out, well, a few months ago, the Zillow 3D home tours. And those actually create a unique tag for
mm-hmm.
your listing to help boost it in the algorithm where it gets shown to more people.
Mm-hmm.
So that's also going to help with like your search engine optimization.
Right.
So it gets shown to more people, and I use a Ricoh Theta camera for that. So it's 360, and it's a cool camera. It has like a two fisheye lens
mm-hmm.
on each side, and it's a stand that goes in each room, and it takes a whole view.
Yeah.
And then, you know, if you've been on Google Maps and you can click the arrows to walk around, that's basically how it is. And you're able to walk through the whole home, without actually going there in person.
Yeah.
So it's nice for, out of state buyers.
Oh yeah.
So it's really good for that. And it's good for, you know, if you have a listing that's super far out and maybe you don't want to drive and these people are like, oh, we don't know. It's like, okay, well, check out this 3D tour and then let me know if you're really serious.
It's great. And I see that a lot of times, you know, I might see in listings where, you know, there's a slideshow presented as a virtual tour. It's not really a virtual tour. So that's what I like about that. People can get the feeling of experiencing the home because they might go, oh, you know, this bedroom is right off the stairway. I don't like that away. And then it saves you time. You can go see what you want to see versus not what you want to see. How long have you been doing it?
4 years.
Okay. All right. It's fabulous. And I know there's a ton of positive. That's how I found you. I found you, I think, in one of the Facebook groups.
Yeah. A lot of people find me.
Yeah. And people were recommending you. So that's kind of like, that's how I work. People recommend me. And I mostly just advertise my listings. I don't advertise myself.
Real estate is very referral based.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I want to work with somebody that, you know, realtors are tough. We're pretty demanding. And
Next day. I needed it yesterday.
I know. Yeah. I mean, I don't think I've done that to you yet, but I mean, it's not that I wouldn't. You know, so I like that in that, you know, at the end of the day, our sellers are looking for results. So it doesn't matter what your intentions were if the product isn't good. So I thought that was really cool and unique and that the photos were really beautiful, but then we also had the search engine optimized thing. So it's all about, like you said, the algorithms. They like certain things, they don't like certain things. Is there anything that the algorithms, like, you know, don't like?
There's a few words that Zillow recommends that you don't use. So that it can paint a negative, you know, because we were talking about luxurious and captivating and stainless and all these things are great words, but there's also bad words. So, for example, potential is a bad word. It's a no-no because it can make people feel like, oh, well, it's not good enough. Like, I don't want to put a lot of work into it. I don't want to spend a lot of money.
It's like dating a guy he's got good potential.
But he's not there yet. So, that can be a turn off for people. Okay. The word opportunity kind of conveys the same thing sometimes.
Okay. That makes sense.
So yeah, things like that. I think another one was clean, because sometimes if you have to say it's clean, it might not be.
Because like if you're a nice person, you'd be like, I'm a nice person. Yeah. Maybe you're not.
Yeah. I'm a nice guy. You probably aren't a nice guy. You have to clarify that.
No, that makes good sense. I didn't really think about that, especially like the opportunity one. I mean, it kind of just, it's like, you know, it's the similes, you know, what it's similar to.
It's how people interpret it.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. So since the MLS has made some changes, we can have a lot more photos. Do you have any recommendations for people for how many photos they should have?
Well, it went from 25 to 50, and I'm hearing now it's 100, right? That's a lot. I don't think anybody actually wants to click through that many photos. I think it's a little crazy. I think that 50 was good. You know, if you have a big listing, like let's say it's, you know, a 6,000 square foot house, I don't think 25 was enough.
Yeah.
Because I used to have like these big houses and, you know, 25 photos just didn't tell the whole story.
Right.
And so I think 50 is a really great place.
You just have to really pick and choose.
Exactly. And I thought 50 was a good cap, and I think 100 is way too much. So I think it depends on the listing. Usually for a smaller home, I do give around like 20, 25, you know, and then for like your medium sized home, I give like 30, 35. And for a very large home, I'll give around 50. I usually don't ever give more than 50. Right. It just doesn't really make sense.
Yeah. And I know we did drone shots on this one, but it's like, I feel like not every house is necessarily, you want a ton of drone shots. Like
if it's very close to its neighbor, you know, if it doesn't really have a pool or, you know, a lake view or anything like it, there's not really anything going on. I don't really see the necessity for that.
Okay.
If it's not really like in close proximity to a golf course or something like that, there's not really a need for it, in my opinion.
Yeah, I think we used it because this particular community had a bunch of amenities, so we spotlighted that.
Right.
And yeah, and that kind of worked well to kind of paint the picture for the area too.
Right.
All right, cool. Well, listen, thank you so much for coming and talking to me today.
Yeah, thank you for having me.